Hi, my name is Barb Emmett, and I'm the host of Dog is Family, the show here where we celebrate dogs in our lives, the ways to nurture them, enjoy them, explore life with them. And we bring you all kinds of new ideas. We always say get your pencil and paper ready because we have a lot to share with you today. I'm very, very excited. We are doing our first Skype broadcast, and we're going to jump right in with my guest, Dr. Linda Stern, Doctor of Veterinary Medicine at VRC in Malvern. And she's on Skype right now, and we're going to be talking about what is integrative veterinary medicine and how can it help dogs stay well. Notice I'm saying stay well, not get well. And I'm hoping that if we enjoy working on this Skyping together, she has so much information to share. I'm hoping she's a guest every month or every other month. So let's turn right to Dr. Linda Stern.
Hello.
Hi, Linda. Welcome for joining us today.
My pleasure. Thank you for inviting me.
Oh, this is very exciting. We always are looking for alternative holistic care. Tell us a little bit about you, your background, and what integrative veterinary medicine means.
Well, I am trained through traditional manners as a veterinarian, and I also, just with being open to nutrition and to my own health, I've always been open to that for my animal patients. So you are what you eat is a very accurate statement. So nutrition is extremely important to help my furry friends to be well balanced. If you're not getting proper nutrition, then you're not going to be healthy. So I do have a master's degree in animal nutrition, so that's where that led into. And then I've always was interested in other more natural ways of healing, just as a side interest. So it opened the doors to me doing other modalities like acupuncture. I'm trained in food therapy, using food as medicine.
Oh, yes.
Okay, so food is more than just adding calories to your body. It can also be healing to your body as well. I'm also trained in a technique called VOM, veterinary orthopedic manipulation. So it's using an indirect technique similar to a chiropractor, and cold laser therapy, which also will help stimulate your body to normalize.
Okay.
So it's a low level laser that can help stimulate your body to heal. So that's part of what I do. Integrative meaning I am trained both traditionally and holistically. Holistically meaning using more natural methods. Holistically meaning looking at the whole animal instead of just parts of them. So holistically, spelt H-O-L-I-S-T, is really W-H-O-L-E, whole, looking at the whole animal.
Yeah, there's a philosophy that we are always talking about here through this program and through the business that I have, Godfrey's Welcome to Dogdom, looking at the whole health of an individual. Do you also get involved in any Chinese herb formulations?
I use whole food supplements to help heal the body, and I also use Chinese herbs, regular herbs, homeopathy. So I do have a lot of resources at my fingertips to help heal the animal.
Oh, that's excellent. And when you look at your practice with at VRC, Veterinary Referral Center, and you're working with the veterinarian and you're trying to come up with a program or a plan for a particular animal, dog or cat, you're working together. How does that all come about? Is it easy to look at that protocol to set that up? How does all that work for people if they were interested in coming to VRC for integrative care?
Well, they could schedule an appointment with just me if they're looking strictly for integrative or holistic care. If they have an animal, for example, with an orthopedic issue and they're not looking to approach it surgically or using hardcore drugs, they can approach it and just call at the practice. I will work with any of their their regular veterinarians.
I was very happy, Dr. Linda, last year when I saw, I think it was last year when you joined the practice down there. I unfortunately did have to use VRC for an emergency situation for one of my Goldens many years ago. And I'm so admiring of the specialists that are there. But when I saw you join, I reached out then and celebrated that and was very anxious to meet with you. You and I are still waiting to meet together. But the philosophies and the ideas and able to really help animals in different ways, I was very excited about. Do you have a case that you could share with us, maybe to give folks some idea about how holistic integrative care has helped? Can you share?
Sure. I have a patient, a mutual patient between the orthopedic division and my division, and this dog was having multiple fractures and weaknesses. And with working together with the orthopedic doctor, we have come up with a support protocol to help this dog. It was out of balance, its spine was out of balance, its hips were out of balance. And so she comes to me on a regular basis for the VOM, and she has done acupuncture and cold laser with this dog. And plus, we tested the dog. I'm big on testing for vitamin D. This dog was significantly deficient in vitamin D, which is very important in bone density. And this dog is doing fabulous as a result of the combined efforts.
Oh, that's excellent to hear. We just love to hear about ways to treat naturally in a healing way. Tell us a little bit about your challenges in integrative veterinary care and maybe what topics we may be able to explore with you in future sessions.
Okay. Challenges, meaning cases that are difficult to handle or sharing with other veterinarians that they're challenged to collaborate with me in helping their patients.
Well, sometimes we see that struggle in the business as well, when we know there's a natural way to go and just trying to come up with a holistic plan, and I'm sure there are challenges that way. What kind of topics might we be able to do in the future that you could share with us? Let's get everybody's appetite ready for new shows coming up.
Allergies.
Oh, allergy. Oh, my goodness. Did you hit on a big one? Yep.
Yep. I work a lot with dog allergies, both here and at my practice in Camp Hill. I work with seizure cases. A lot of dogs having seizure issues. A lot of times seizures and allergies are actually very much related. It's part of the liver meridian that can be out of balance.
Excellent.
And I work a lot with orthopedic cases, you know, dogs with hip dysplasia, arthritis.
A lot of topics. I think we can go in a lot of different directions, right? Maybe even some demoing of some things that might go on. This is very exciting, and I need to thank you. I'm sure you're very busy and need to run off to some other things. We had a short amount of time to be together. Dr. Linda, I am so grateful for you to want to be part of this, to help to share the information that's out there about integrative care. Actually, one of our guests today has had some orthopedic, a lot of issues that I know you have to run, but we so look forward to being with you in the future. And again, thank you for your time. And I'm hoping that some of our viewers will be writing in or calling in and giving us their questions. And we are so limited in our resources in our county when it comes to natural holistic care. So thanks again. This is an exciting venture. We hope we can see you next month.
My pleasure, and I look forward to trying to help as many furry friends as possible.
Thank you, Dr. Linda. Have a wonderful day saving lives. Bye-bye.
Thank you. Bye-bye.
Okay. Well, folks, that was very interesting, I think, for all of us. And now we're going to transition into our next segment of the program. Let me introduce some very, very interesting folks. To my left is Alice Fisher. Hi, Alice.
Hi, how are you?
Good, thanks for joining us. And who do we have aside of you?
Oh, this is Hannah.
Hi, Hannah.
She's a German short-haired pointer.
And to my right, I'm going to thank Nicole Weersing for showing today.
Thank you.
Nicole is a canine conditioning and wellness coordinator and specialist at Godfrey's Welcome to Dog Dog.
Yeah.
So we have a partnership here going on with what's happening, and we can't wait to share with you Hannah's story. And Alice is going to share some of that with us. Tell us a little bit more about Hannah, Alice.
Hannah is 7 years old. Back in September, it's been a year and a half, so she was five. She was in a car accident. And she was in a crate, but they hit a pole and she was thrown inside the crate and broke a vertebrae in her back. So she has two rods in her back. And it left her back legs paralyzed. So we have been working to get her back to where she needs to be.
When did that happen, Alice? How many years ago?
It was August of 2014.
August of 2014. Yes. All of the viewers here, who love dogs as much as we do, hearing Hannah's story, please stay with us and be inspired, because it can break your heart. But it's hopeful and we're moving all forward, right, Alice?
That's right.
So she was thrown from even a crate, which we all say when you're traveling in a car.
She was in an SUV, yes.
And that's about, you know, that's what we're supposed to do, keep them safe in the car. But the situation ended with a tragic accident that way. So here she is. How did you proceed? What was going through your mind? What did the veterinarian say who had operated? What was her prognosis at the time?
Well, the first vet that they took her to was an emergency vet.
Oh, yeah.
And their recommendation was that we put her to sleep.
Oh, gosh.
So we were actually, she was with a friend of ours, and it was their car that had the accident. But we were in Maine, so my husband and I started driving home, and I immediately called another friend of mine who recommended that we take her to Metropolitan Vet.
The specialist,
at Metropolitan, Dr. Cobble.
Cobble.
Yes. So they took her there, they did an MRI there, and she was very hopeful. She said that she thought that if we put the rods in her back, it would, you know, keep her spine straight.
Straight.
And that, you know, eventually she should be able to walk. And even if she couldn't, she could use a cart to get around, which we used, and have a good life.
Yes.
So that was our choice.
And that was your choice. And your heart and your head said, this is what we're doing.
Yep.
Right?
Yeah.
Right? You're positive.
It was not really much of a choice for us to make.
Well,
because she is part of our family.
I would say the same thing. So you found your way to the cart here, I guess, behind her.
It's back here.
Which she uses for most of her mobility, right?
It does.
And then you found your way to rehabilitation for canines. I don't know how many folks understand or even know what's available in canine rehabilitation. So many times people have situations with their dog and they don't even realize that there's help out there. I know we did stories on carts or on braces and things like that. Mm-hmm. What have you been able to, where did you go and how did you proceed with rehab, and are there specialists?
Well, after she was at Metropolitan for a week, she went to Westchester Veterinary Clinic. Who also has a rehab department. And she actually stayed there for, I think she was there for 3 weeks.
Wow.
With them in their hospital. And they started doing rehab with her. They do all kinds of different rehab. They have a pool. That's where she started.
She started her first rehab in a pool.
In a pool, okay. Yes, so that she was totally
buoyant.
Yeah, so she started that. And then she moved on to an underwater treadmill so that it keeps her buoyant and her back legs, you know, can move without any weight from her body. They also do the cold laser
that Dr. Linda talked about.
Yeah, she talked about. And they also do acupuncture. So Hannah has had all of those modalities.
Yeah. Did you have like a protocol plan for a period of weeks and move through those modalities equally? Like some weeks were one modality, some weeks were another modality? Or did you start? You started with water and then?
We did. And she would do water and mostly the laser.
The laser.
Twice a week. Twice after a week. She left the facility. So I would go down and take her down twice a week. And then they moved on to doing the acupuncture. And we do that maybe once a month.
Once a month.
So stay here.
Such an inspiration for this girl. So at some point, I know you came to Godfrey's and you had said, I'm trying to do whatever I can to help her keep moving forward. And I remember talking with you, and she would call. This woman is a very determined and loving, and she is going to do everything. And she called, and I continued to say, we can only work with dogs after they're released from rehabilitation. We are wellness, as Nicole is trained in wellness and conditioning for dogs after being released to rehabilitation. So we had to get that back, and I had to work with the veterinarians there to say, she's ready. Do anything that you can for Hannah. And Nicole and I talked, and she thought, yes, I have some really good ideas about how we can work. Oh, what's Hannah having now?
Her cream cheese.
She needs a t-shirt that says, I work for cream cheese.
Yeah. She does have a t-shirt that says, I work for cream cheese. Oh my gosh, honey, you're
it
amazing.
It is wonderful.
She loves cream cheese.
It has to be a specific kind.
Oh, it does. It does.
Not to say she's not loved, and very, very... well taken care of. So when you came to us, or to Godfrey's with Nicole's help, what did you think how did we come to working out a plan? And maybe that's between Nicole and Alice. And where do we start? I mean, do you want to speak first what you were looking for?
Well, I was looking for a way to get Hannah's legs stronger because she didn't have, even though she was working on healing, with the cold laser and, doing the water treadmill.
She had the low muscle tone.
Yeah. Yeah, she didn't really have much
muscle. The muscle tone wasn't there. Oh, my goodness, when I see her now, she's got her muscle tone.
So now she's getting that back, and you can actually see the muscles in her back legs. And we wanted to get movement back, which we are starting to get, some movement.
I saw her yesterday again.
Yeah.
Nicole, do you want to speak with what was going through your head and how you came up with some thoughts about how to develop a private program for Hannah to build her muscles? Because each dog that I know Nicole works with, she customizes the program, and this was a different type of a challenge.
Yes, it's all individually programmed. I knew with Hannah, the first thing I wanted to do was work on her core because that is the support system. And when Hannah first came, I knew that I wanted to work on her back end. I wanted to get her muscles strong. I wanted to get her confident. And so what we started with was getting her used to all the equipment. And I'm going to show you some pieces here. And we're going to show the first video of the peanut, which is all about the unstable surfaces and works on her core. So we're going to show that
wanna
first
see that
video.
Yep. Okay, so that's what we're looking at, peanut.
When you first get the peanut, I usually tell you to put it like in the corner of a room.
Yeah.
So that you have a wall, and then you're here to stabilize.
Okay.
This is not a toy, it's a training tool. Okay. The softer the peanut, the easier it is to work. Okay. The harder it is, the harder it is to work. With this smaller peanut like this, I tend to stand like this because I can control it with my legs. But you can sit in a chair and do the same thing. Okay? And you're tall enough, and he's small enough, you could probably sit here easily and control him. And you need a harness of some type to where you have a handle in case he should start to fall. Okay? Just like we were doing that sit, he's put on the elevated thing.
Yeah.
You would eventually get to the point that he'd be sitting here with his foot here, other foot, sorry, and standing up.
Okay?
And you don't think about it, but if you do this without putting weight here, you're using your butt and your thighs. Okay, so we're strengthening this part. Then the other thing we do is what we call puppy push-ups. So he would put his front foot up here, and he'd be standing like this. We would lower the cookie to make him go down like this, and then he would come back up.
Okay.
So it's just like you and I doing push-ups.
Yeah.
Okay. Good. Beautiful. Okay, so he's up. So not nice big stretch for his back, for his hips. You see that?
Going on with the peanut, I would have loved to have gotten some of our video of these folks working with Hannah. We just didn't get that put together, so you're seeing a little bit of a demo. And then we have another one that we can show.
Yep, real quick, it's just the wobble board that we're going to demo on.
You can put a FitPaws donut holder underneath a FitPaws giant wobble board. Using this combination of equipment is great for large and giant breed core strengthening exercises. Using the donut holder underneath the FitPaws wobble board will make the wobble board more dynamic. It's great for senior dog core strength training and confidence building. Using this combo is great for athletic conditioning, canine rehab, and many more uses. Check out our website for more info. Thanks for watching.
We're going to show you Nicole is demonstrating with Alice and with Hannah doing the work, and you can see that they're doing the work as well. Alice is very, very involved. There's Hannah on the wobble board. Nicole, tell us a little bit more.
All right, so what we're doing is cookie stretches here. We want to lift the head up and down and side to side, and what we're doing is engaging her core, and we are building, it's all about the unstable surfaces, and the wobble board is fabulous because it's working with her balance. And a lot of times we'll use this, which helps with neurostimulation here, where these are called, this is a disc, and this is called a, these are called pods. So what we'll do a lot of times is, in the program, we'll put the pods underneath her back end, so it helps, you know, with paw placement, body awareness, it really helps her to stop the knuckling, because our goal for Hannah is we want her to stop knuckling. She's pulling herself forward. Alice, if you want to talk about what you've seen in the improvement with the program and how Hannah's been doing.
She actually surprised me last week. We were at a picnic and I got her out of her cart, and we were kind of in a wooded setting, and all of a sudden she took off and I couldn't catch her. She's been using her back legs to push herself and actually pulling them front and trying to stand, which is really encouraging.
I don't know if you can see, when we first started, she had no muscle mass. So you can see with the exercises that we've been doing, we meet about once a week, you can see how strong and how her muscles here, the flexor, it's fabulous. She's building confidence on the equipment, and she's having a wonderful time, and she's happy, and it's wonderful to be able to work with Alice and Hannah and be a part of her recovery. It's wonderful, and we are going to absolutely get her to walk again. Right, Hannah?
Yes.
Hannah's going to walk again, right?
We're very hopeful. Right. I want her to get her more comfortable. She relies so much on her front. So we're going to hope the best for Hannah and get her to walk again.
We also have a canine treadmill, and Nicole, I think you were trying to work with that. Still, right now, she's still not ready, I guess, with how to keep her stabilized on the treadmill yet.
But so we use the peanut. So we put the peanut underneath here. So she releases a little bit of her core, so she relies more so on her back end.
Her back end.
Yes.
And those pods, while looking interesting, I mean, they got little nubs. You're thinking, what is all this for? How does this work?
Yep, it's for neurostimulation. It helps with body awareness.
So her paw Alice is demonstrating that. I don't know if you can see it. Poor Hannah, she's like, okay,
she's
Mama, I'm doing it.
Thank goodness for cream cheese. So yes, this is what's going to help her to stop knuckle, because when she pulls herself forward, we want her to be able to bring her paws all the way up. So using the paw pods, good girl Hannah, using the paw pods is how we're going to hopefully get there for Hannah. Wonderful.
That looks awesome. My goodness, such progress. And when she's talking, you're talking knuckling, you're talking about the neurological,
the neurologic
issues,
sensory
of turning the paw down to come back up.
Up.
So the progress, if you'd sum it up, ladies, what would you say?
We're going to do it.
We are.
That's all we want to hear.
We are going
to hear that. We're going to do it.
Good
Thank
girl,
you.
Hannah.
Thank you, Hannah. You are such a dear. Alice, do you do a lot of this at home as well?
I do some. I have a small disc that I use. And I also do some things with her while outside.
Outside?
Yeah, so that she, because in the apartment she's not real excited about
working. So you go outside with her. She's a very joyful dog. Another thing about why we love dogs. We want to thank you so much for joining us today. It was very exciting for all of us to do Skyping with an integrative veterinarian, Dr. Linda Stern, to have these lovely ladies here who are very committed to Hannah's improvement and walking again. She is a dear dog. I'm going to cry. So thank you. Bye.